Boom, 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 boom. Wagwan going, peeps? Don't know. Welcome back to Taz Kitchen. Alright, well, today, we're going to go a Jamaican traditional dish phone. Alright, a thing called rondon. Yes, rondon. You can make rondon with anything you want. But today, we're going to do boom. We're going to go a thing mackerel rondon. So, here we do. Watch the intro and forward back right us up and make a rondon. See? Peace. I'm out.
Alright, so peeps, so for start your tin mackerel rondon, I'll give you a list of all of the ingredients that we need. So first and foremost, you need 2 cups of coconut milk, okay? Alright, if you don't like coconut milk, you can use your coconut. You can blend the coconut, you can grate it and use it, alright? But you need 2 cups, okay? You need 1 tomato, slice up, alright? You need 1 stalk of thyme, alright? You need 2 stalk of scallion, you need you know, a couple pieces of sweet pepper, you know, after this is optional, all right? Me want my thing look pretty and nice, so as I said, this is your food, so you can put what you want tonight, so. As I said, sweet pepper is optional. I have 1 onion right here, so, all right, 1/2 scotch bonnet pepper, all right, remember, with your pepper intake, if you cannot take pepper, do not use so much scotch bonnet pepper, all right? And we have 2 peg of chopped garlic right here, all right? We're gonna need some pimento seed, black pepper, and of course, you don't know, the star of the dish, jack mackerel, all right? And you need some coconut oil. If you don't want to use coconut oil, you can use vegetable oil, all right? So here we are, let's get cooking. All right. Okay, so peeps, so, all right. So now, the cooking process, all right? So you're going with the 2 cups of coconut milk, right? In a separate pan. All right, so that's the 2 cups of coconut milk right there, right? In the chef world, this is called a reduction, so you're gonna reduce that, all right? All right, so you're gonna leave the coconut milk and that's gonna come to a boil, all right? Because you want your cluster and all that out of that. Okay, so over here you have a separate pan and now you're going with 2 tablespoons of coconut oil, all right? Yes, and my hands are clean, people, so yeah, clean hands when you're cooking and don't be afraid to get your hands dirty. Mad. All right, so you're going with 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. Yes, this is good. I remember when me a little boy, me used to beg my grandmother, yo, for make this to me every day. Beg her. Alright, so that's your coconut oil right there. Okay. And if you want, you can use vegetable oil. Alright. I don't want to use vegetable oil. Alright. Coconut oil. With the coconut milk and all that, yo, trust me, it give you a nice flavor. Yeah, all right, yes, all right. Stove kind of mess up, but you don't know that time in the cooking. All right, cool. What you're gonna do, people, you're going with some chopped garlic. All right, so this is 2 pegs of chopped garlic, and you're going with that in your coconut oil. All right. All right, that soon starts sizzle. The oil not hot as yet. All right. That soon starts sizzle. All right. All right. Your stove with your coconut milk right now, you got to make sure it's you keep it on high because you want that to boil. All right, then. Yes. All right. All right. My garlic starts sizzle. And then, right now, the scent will come out of that garlic here with the coconut oil in it. A trouble. Alright. And you just have to saute all of your seasoning. Some people don't saute them seasoning. Alright, some people don't. Me, I like to saute my seasoning. Alright, if you want, you can just like put your coconut milk to boil and then afterwards you can add in your seasoning to it and your mackerel, whatever you use. Rondon can make with a variety of many different things, alright? Yes, alright, so while your garlic is saute, right? Then you're gonna go in with a scotch bonnet pepper, alright? Yes, so the pepper, the oil, and the garlic, nice aroma, all of them come together. Cool? Yes, yeah, so as me that say, a lot of people make rundown with a whole lot of different things. You can make it with chicken back. You can make it with red herring. You can make it with salt mackerel. Right? Anything you choose to make your rundown with, that's yours. Alright. Now, coconut milk is coming to a boil. Alright? Alright, now you turn down the stove. Alright? Turn down the stove. Yes, we want it to come to a boil. Alright, because you want to reduce that. Alright? I said turn on your stove and make that boil. Next, now you're going with the chopped onions. Alright? Going with the onions. Give me coconut milk over this bubble. Yes. Alright, yes. Alright, now tell you a little secret about me and rundown now. Right? As a little youth, it's like my mother used to work at one bar. You know? And me used to go to work with her. And I never like breadfruit. You couldn't get me to eat breadfruit for love nor money, you know? So I never like breadfruit. And then what happened is like one day, I see somebody bring some breadfruit come around there with some rundown, but me never know it's a rundown. And my mother said, taste it, man, it tastes good. And I try it. And from that day, I saw me start eat breadfruit. So yes, I love rundown. All right. Now, you're going, all right, with a chopped scallion. The scallion to that. Yes. Sauteed them and nice. The room out of these people, me, I tell you, no, it smells so good. All right, now I got to switch back to the coconut milk. All right, look at that. See a coconut milk a boil? Yes. All right. After you turn up your stove, people, remember you can turn down back your stove to like medium heat. Alright, because you want to get it to start boil. Make sure your coconut milk come to a complete boil. Okay? You can turn down your stove after that. Alright, for medium heat, make it go and reduce. As I said before, coconut milk will hurt your belly. Alright. That's how go and sizzle up. Then now you are going with the sweet pepper. Alright? And sweet pepper is optional. If you want, you don't have to use sweet pepper in your rundown. Right, this is optional. I use it because I want my color. I like the coloring of the thing. All right, yes. You can use red if you want. You can use green if you want. Up to you. All right. So meanwhile, then I'll go and saute it down. Now you are going with your tomato. All right. So your tomato and your thyme. You're going with that. Yeah, this looks so good already. Never done yet. All right, you keep on stirring that. Always, is it? Remember, it's a constant stir. And me right now, me is a non-stick pot. All right, so me is a non-stick pot. Continue to stir on the veggies, seasoning, and make them go and cook out. Yeah. This, as me say, is a Jamaican traditional dish, this, you know, old folks love them something here. Yeah, everything coming together. All right, as we say, saute the veggies until them become translucent. All right, cool. Ah, nice. Now what you're going to do now, you're going with a little tubes of black pepper, alright? Going with the black pepper over that. And me go with my black pepper and my seasoning, alright? Me no go with the black pepper in the coconut milk or in the tin mackerel. Me go with it right here, so. Alright? You can choose to go with it wherever you want. You can put it after you add the tin mackerel or after you add the coconut milk. Me want to put it over the veggies, alright? Cool. Guys, give it a nice little kick when you kind of saute it in with the veggies and your seasoning. Okay, the next move is now the star of the meal. Yes. All right, so boom, open up your mackerel. All right, open up your mackerel. Alright, we open up the mackerel, stay right there. Alright. Add the mackerel to your pot. Yeah. It's not that chunkiness, people. Look at that. One more in there. Alright. Yes. Alright, add the mackerel to your pot. Now, most people, after adding the mackerel, them kind of get look of water and wash out the mackerel tin. Alright? We don't want to do that. Alright. This is my next trick. So now, when you add the mackerel, right, what you need to do, I'm just going like this. I'm going to debone my mackerel now. Alright? I'm going to take out that middle section right there. See that? Take out that. See that? Have a plate right there. Scrape it right. You open another middle piece again of the mackerel. Go right into the middle. And you take out the bone. Alright? Yes. Sieve out the bone. You can, actually, you can do this before you add the mackerel to the pot. Alright? I'm just doing it my way. Let me say, this is not restaurant food, so you can cook it how you want it. Alright? So, my debone tin mackerel. Yeah, man. But enough people never know that. Alright, what you need to do now, alright, you just take your spoon and you just break your mackerel in two off. Break your mackerel in two off right there. Alright. See that? Yes. Alright. Now what you're going to do now, your coconut milk, alright, that is reduced. Alright, yes, so you see all that crust and all that coming up off of that. That's all you need from your coconut milk. Alright. Then you're gonna take your coconut milk. You're gonna take your coconut milk now. And you're gonna add it to your mackerel. Add the coconut milk to your mackerel, you know? Yes. Right here. Alright, good. Get that out of the way. Alright. Whoa, look at that, people. Look there. Alright. Last but not least, we are going with some pimento seed. Alright. You need about 4 to 5. I roughly, me I go with 6. Alright, this is about 6. Let me see my count, right? 6, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so that's 8. Alright, you can go 6, 7, 8, 4 to 5, whatever. You don't want to overpower it, right? So you just about that apartment to see the night. You just stir that and make it just slowly cook. But basically, this done now, people. This done, But you want now the coconut milk. Forget infused with all that flavor of the coconut oil and the tin mackerel, right? And your seasoning and all of that. So you want all of that get infused. So what you're gonna do, you just keep on stirring. Alright? Keep your stove on medium heat and make this bubble up a little bit. Alright?
Alright, so there you have it, peeps. Run down the tin mackerel done simple, quick and easy right here in Taz's Kitchen. Alright, yeah, so people, so hit the notification bell so anytime I post a new video, you know, we'll see it, you know, and also hit subscribe, leave a comment, alright, and a like, and also, I'll be leaving description, right, in the description box below of, my methods, right, and ingredients of how to cook a tin mackerel rundown. So you don't know no peeps, till further ado, from my kitchen to yours, you don't know. Big up on yourself, see? Boom, I'm out.